Greetings. I was listening to a video from ABNSAT, and David Wood asked a question regarding a particular ayat Islam avoids, Surah 355. I've addressed it in a video several years ago, but last night it took on a special meaning. Last night, it was like hearing Surah 355 for the first time. You see, David Wood took patient time to lay out the claims of Islam. Patiently, irrefutably, David made the case that the disciples were Muslims.
Allahu Akbar!
Well, at least according to the Quran. Surah 352. And when Jesus sensed their faithlessness, he said, Who will be my helpers towards Allah? The disciples said, We will be helpers of Allah. We have faith in Allah and bear witness that we are Muslims. I admit that sounds crazy to Christians, but as crazy as it sounds, let's imagine this is true. Let's imagine the disciples, who had never heard the word Allah or the word Muslims, would declare their obedience to Allah and call themselves Muslim just out of obedience and submission to Jesus. Okay? Fair enough? Well, based on that assumption, it is certain now that the disciples are Muslim, right? I'll grant that Judas was not a Muslim, betraying Prophet Jesus and all that. But you would be certain to agree that the disciples were therefore the true followers of Jesus and Allah, right? We have just read the Quran. The disciples were Muslims. They said Shahada. The Quran says they were true believers. Which brings me to Surah 355. The Yusuf Ali translation. Behold, Allah said, O Jesus, I will take thee and raise thee to myself, and clear thee of the falsehoods of those who blaspheme. I will make those who follow thee superior to those who reject faith, meaning Islam, to, or until, the day of resurrection. 2 points here. 1. Allah said, He would clear Jesus of the falsehoods of those who blaspheme. Now, this is Allah allegedly speaking to Jesus before the crucifixion. Allah said, I will raise thee up. Therefore, Allah had not yet done so. So before the crucifixion, men were blaspheming, according to Muhammad's Quran. And what was the blasphemy the Quran claims men committed? Men were calling Jesus the Son of God. This means men were calling Jesus the Son of God before the crucifixion. Sorry to interrupt, but doesn't that sort of destroy the claim that this whole Son of God belief only came about 30 years later by a man named Paul? Just thinking. I mean, you have Allah's very own word that men were saying this blasphemy before Jesus was lifted up to Allah. But I'll cut Allah some slack. After all, he didn't swear by Jesus' life to Jesus. Allah didn't say, By the cross of deception I will thus and so. By the lives of the disciples. By the secret holy mosque of Al-Aqsa. Now, if Allah had done that, heck, even I'd consider being a believer. That right there is point one of my new favorite surah. I will make those who follow thee. Allah makes a promise about those who follow thee. Now, as I have shown earlier, the disciples who followed Jesus were Muslims, according to Islam anyway. Remember, this is Islam's claim, Islam's story, Islam's tale, Islam's concept. The disciples, the followers of Jesus, were Muslims. And Allah made a promise to Jesus about his followers. I will make those who follow thee superior to those who reject faith. Doesn't Allah mean superior to the Christians? And that is really where the damning confusion of this ayat begins to unravel. Allah told Jesus, Allah promised Jesus, that his good Muslim disciples would be superior over the unbelievers who blaspheme. And yet there is not one scrap or atom or hint or record of anyone from before Muhammad ever following Islam. Ever. Not one scrap. We have more proof that Alibaba was real. In fact, the good Muslim disciples who swore their oath to be Allah's helpers were abducted by aliens mere hours after Allah abducted Jesus, and replaced by men who all went to their deaths proclaiming the very blasphemy that Allah was going to cure. They all faced beatings and whippings and prison, and all claimed that Jesus was the resurrected Son of God. And that means Allah did not tell Jesus the truth. Not only did Allah not make them superior, but Allah could not stop them from becoming chief among the blasphemers. If Surah 355 is true, and Allah said these things, Allah lied to Jesus. Allah said he would make the good Muslim disciples superior. But hey, they were only fishermen. One might excuse Allah's inability to trick them into being warriors as he tricked Muhammad. One might even forgive Allah for promising more than he could deliver. But I think Allah is trying to claim he is God. Or at least Muhammad is trying to claim his Allah is a God. But God is not a man that he should lie. And yet Allah said something that is very clearly not true. And it just does not get any better for Allah, brother. When men shoot off their mouths, we excuse their mistake with, they did not know. But is that really an excuse Allah, the all-knowing, all-seeing, all-deceiving, can hide behind? Do you really want to claim Allah simply did not know what would happen? Or Allah simply could not control what happened? There is simply no excuse imaginable why Allah lied to Jesus. And that is why Surah 355 is reason number 9 why I will forever reject Islam. Allah lied to Jesus. This Allah cannot be the God who does not lie. Allah lied just like a man lies. And that is why Surah 355 is reason number 9, I will forever reject Islam. And you should realize this Allah of the Quran who lied in Surah 355, he is not God. You do not need to fear the Allah of the Quran who lies. You do not need to fear the threats of the Quran either. You need to fear the God of the Bible who does not lie. And the God of the Bible whom I fear has foretold the fate of the Allah of the Quran. And that is why I reject Islam forever. Now, if anyone claiming to follow this Allah wants to explain his lie, please post your excuse. Go ahead and explain why Allah lied to Jesus and said the disciples would be superior, even though they became the chief blasphemers. Or if you want to learn more about the God who never lies, post or send me a YouTube message. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.